You guys absolutely killed it on the last couple of like challenges. That's why I jumped the truck in the first place. But let's crank it up a notch. Let's see if this video gets 30,000 likes, I will put my 44-inch mud boggers on the T-Rex. I don't care how I have to do it, what I have to cut, I will put them on. Those tires, so in other words, those things right there. These are the same size as what's on the truck right now. You're going from that to that. I mean, I'm not sure if you guys can really understand what I'm talking about here. We're talking about a 44-inch mud bogger. Like, that's a 17-inch tire, a 44-inch mud bogger on the T-Rex. You guys can do it. I know you can. Make sure this upload gets 30,000 likes and you'll see it. Good luck. See that these were mounted here? This clip is completely broken. A lot of damage. Like, let's call it what it is, a lot of damage.
Oh yeah! Woo!
Okay, there we go. That should be good. Leave that there for a few days and we'll get back to it. Quick update for you guys. The Raptor giveaway is officially over. That's right, the Raptor giveaway is over, so you won't have to hear me talk about it. Unless you want to enter to win the LBZ, then you can, link down below. Yes, the Raptor giveaway is over, and we will have a winner for you in about 10 days from the giveaway company, the official legal company that does, that picks the winner and all that good stuff. So about 10 days, we'll have a winner for you. Guys, hope y'all are having a great day. Let's start this upload, and I just want to say thank you all for the amazing support on the last upload. Now, don't get me wrong, I thought it would get like pretty good views. However, I did not think it would blow up the way that it did. I got DMs from everybody and emails. I saw it was posted by Road and Track, Car and Driver, all these different forums. I mean, it was crazy. You know, my channel's usually pretty low key. I don't get that much attention, and it was wild, and I didn't really expect it because, to be honest with you, I love this truck. I think it's great. And had I not done the like challenge, I know everyone thinks like, oh, you were gonna jump it anyway. And I might've done like a little jump, but I would not have done anything like that if it wasn't for the like challenge. But I'm a man of my word. Bill Steen even reached out and said that they want the shocks from the truck. To break them down and reconstruct them and see how they did for the jump, gonna send me a whole new set. So I thought that was pretty neat. Like, Bilstein, the company that makes the shocks only for the T-Rex, make other shocks, but they make them special for this truck. They want them to see how it did because they did not think anyone would do what I did with it. But you know, give it a few years, the Raptor, what we've seen, give it a few years, people will jump it and jump it the wrong way. However, now we are in kind of a unique scenario because, let's be honest, the truck is pretty rough. It works, it goes down the road straight. I drove it home, by the way, at 85 miles per hour, heated seats on, everything working, truck was great. Even the alignment's like pretty good. It's a little bit left, but it goes down the road straight. So the wheel is left, but the truck is straight, which means, like, you know, frame-wise and everything should be pretty good. Now, there might be some issues that you can't see with the naked eye, but it actually does go very straight and nice down the road. But yeah, the body is, like I said, rough. And now that I've had like a whole day to kind of look over the truck and see really take my time and look at what's wrong with it, there are more things. So let me go over all that damage right now. And I guess I'll back it away from the Blazer. And I also have my 2020 Raptor here, which I thought would be appropriate because this is the first truck I ever jumped. Besides that one. And this is the one, this is the truck that I built that, well, that Bailey built that jump for down there at the farm. That truck did very well. The only thing that broke on it was a bed mount and the front bump, the front skid plate is a little bent. But other than that, that truck did fine. Now, I will say though, the T-Rex got jumped a lot harder, a lot higher and a lot farther. And don't forget, this truck is much heavier than a Raptor and it went that much farther.
Oh yeah! That thing was
flying. Look where it landed. The Raptor, for comparison, folks, landed here. The Dodge landed out here. Holy cow.
Which really tells you how fast. I mean, I looked at the footage, and I think I was doing about 60 miles per hour off that ramp, which is, yeah, unreal. Don't try this at home, by the way. I'm lucky I'm okay. Like, really, I could have been hurt. I am good, by the way. Like, I'm not really sore. Everything's fine, which is a miracle. But don't try, please don't try this. Please don't try this, because I don't know if I'm lucky or what. But I mean, that was pretty freaking brutal in there. I'm not gonna lie. Anyway, let me see if the keys are in here. I mean, yeah, it's a mess in the truck, guys. It's a mess. Now, the front is okay. Back here, broken glass everywhere. Yeah, super cool. I'm gonna have to get this all vacuumed out. The back window is completely destroyed. Even these little, like, whatever these are. Oh, they're like rubber anyway. I am going to get a back window. I think that's the only thing I'm going to replace on the truck, and I'll talk about that in a second. But I will replace the back window. Really did like this truck. I drove it back from Indiana. It was like 600 miles. It was great. I ate McDonald's in it. Like, I loved it. It was awesome. And then you guys had to give me those 25,000 likes, and this is what happens. You all did this. I didn't do this. You all did this. A little bit louder now that it has no back window, but it's, you know, it's running well. No issues there. She just crossed over 1,000 miles, guys, which means the good news is that we can really, you know, the break-in period is over, so we can really kind of like, now we can actually have fun with it. You'll notice the body lines on the truck don't really line up that well anymore. Now, I did not look at the truck when I first got it. Like, I didn't really, like, ooh, examine every body line, because I don't care. But, you know, every new car, it can be a little bit, you know, there might be a gap here, but I don't think the gap would be that bad. It's like, I can fit my entire finger in. I got fat fingers. I can fit them in right here in this gap. And then if you come over to the other side, you'll notice that it's not quite like that. So I'm feeling like that's a little bit tweaked, not how it's supposed to be. And the hood, like, I feel like it moves a little bit, but whatever, I don't care about that. The front bumper, yeah, that's pretty much toast. This side is good, but this side is bad. And this is the one that it kind of, like, when I jumped, it kind of went like this for some reason. I don't know, the Raptor landed pretty much flat. This one, however, did not land flat. I actually tried to get the dirt out, and it's so packed in there that I can't. So the bumper is toast, the front bumper. I'm going to remove that. And the skid plate is, I mean, look at the, that's a thick skid plate too. And it's, it's completely bent up. It, like, if you look at the front of the truck, I mean, it looks like it wasn't a proper accident, which I guess really is kind of what it was. Quick update, and I took the skid plate off. You'll see that these were mounted here. These extra shock reservoirs were mounted here. This clip is completely broken, as you can see. So these were mounted in here, and they were just resting on the skid plate. So when I unbolted the skid plate, they fell out. These would have been mounted right here on top of one another. And you can see where there's a little spot for them. Unfortunately, it is broken. So we'd have to get one of those new things. I mean, there's a lot of damage. Like, let's call it what it is. A lot of damage. It would take a long time to get all these parts, and I mean, it's in pretty rough shape. So it's, for me at this current time, it's not worth fixing, and I might as well just have a lot of fun with it. Mechanically, we are 100%, we're good to go, and I think that's pretty incredible. Now here, like, this fog light is ruined. I'll have to pull that out, but look, everything is like stuck in here. The whole front bumper is gone for sure. That's a write-off, it's gone. And then you look over here, you got the wheel liner. That's broken beyond any repair. This whole plastic piece is missing. And this is why I kind of feel like I am in a unique situation here. Now, don't get me wrong, the truck is fixable easily. If I had the parts, the truck would be fixable, but I feel like that's kind of like, it's boring. Oh, great, I fix it, and then it's back to the way it was a week ago, and who cares? But now that I have it damaged this much, do I just keep going and make it like that? Because imagine, like, that's a really fun off-roader, but imagine if that had 700, a Hellcat engine, a Hellcat powertrain, a four-wheel drive, locking diffs. I feel like this could be the most fun, epic vehicle on the channel. I think the move might be to just say, to heck with it, and we make it a ridiculous off-roader. Now, let me keep showing you the damage here. You know, that's just not good at all. not good at all. I'm gonna rip that right out. What is this? Could rip that whole thing out. Yeah, the rear window, we gotta get that fixed because I don't wanna be, as dumb as it sounds, I don't wanna ruin my nice interior. It's a really nice place to be, even if it's gonna be an off-road rig. And I don't want it to get all wet and moldy. That's gonna be gross. So we gotta fix the freaking window. Dent over here, and the whole, if you look at the whole bed, it's kind of like bent. And then you can see where the cab, where the bed went up into the cab right over here. So if I jump, you can see, look at the paint missing there. Bed hit the cab and created that big dent right there. Driver's side, pretty good. No issues on the body there. And then around the back, my bed step is complete. I like this too, and it's completely broken. Like, that doesn't line up at all anymore, and I'm gonna cut the mufflers off now for sure. Tailgate, not doing good. Ripped apart. I don't even know how that really happened, to be honest with you. I mean, I can see it being bashed out. How it got ripped open, I don't know. But here's what I love. There you go, still works. So tailgate is working well. I see no issues there whatsoever. That's totally fine. Tailgate is working. That's all that matters. Here is a piece of the front bumper, I believe. Here is the hidden damage that you would never know until you pop the hood, which I found out later on with a full examination here. Just take this off. Raptor eating a T-Rex. Great. Now, the only issue is, yes, the battery and the ECU is mounted on a plastic tray that is bolted to the fender here. You can see. Well, the problem is when you jump the truck 20 feet in the air, when you jump the truck 20 feet in the air across 40 yards, I feel like it's not good enough because my battery snapped off and you can see it's laying in the engine bay. So my battery is just laying in here at the current time. So that's where that's at. We will have to remedy. So I'm gonna have Regal Metalworks, the company that built that for me, I'm gonna have them fab up like a metal thing that will be a little bit stronger and we'll mount that back into place. So that's gotta be fixed as well. But the rest of it, you know, I'm not gonna worry about it. I feel like, again, it would take too long to get the parts. I don't really care. I'm having fun with the truck. I still love the truck. So let's keep going. Let's make it a fun off-roader. And I do believe, if I'm not mistaken, the bolt pattern for this truck is the same as the wheels I happen to have on those 44s.
Great success.
Something is smoking.
Who's smoking?
We don't know what yet, but something's hot. Tire on fire?
It's not the tire.
Wait, fire, I'll drive it in the
Whoa! Car.
I think it's mud on the engine.
I'm burning mud all day.
Jesus.
It's so muddy.
What a disaster.
So
dude.
Muddy.
I think I can actually fix this here. Oh, look at that. That's perfect. Yeah, it's going to be an off-road rig. I think we're past the point of fixing it. That's boring anyway. Let's make it the coolest freaking T-Rex on the planet. These then are actually made out of fiberglass, which I did not know. It's like a Corvette. So that's kind of a neat fact there. Hoping you guys can get 30,000 likes on the video because I really want to figure out how I can possibly fit 44s on this truck. But I think we can do it. I think we can get it. It's going to be tough, but you know, we'll have to do a lot of cutting, but I'm pretty freaking excited to figure it out. That's where I'm at with the T-Rex. And let me just say, you know, I didn't intend on writing off the whole truck. I didn't, you know, that's Whistle and Diesel's thing. I didn't intentionally destroy it, but it happened. And now I can only have fun with it. So, I mean, don't get mad at me. First of all, it's your fault for getting the likes on the video. It's not even my fault. I cannot be held responsible for this. Now that it did happen, I'm actually like really excited to see where it goes because that became so much fun and so interesting. And I feel like that's going to be 10 times as cool. All right, guys, the shop is freaking crazy. We got the joggers right here, the 717 joggers that everyone loves. Now, this is what the guy who won the C6 ZR1 got. He got the joggers. Maybe they're lucky. I don't know. Check them out. We got the long sleeve shirts here in Chain Designs. We got the long sleeve OD green with the 717 badge on it. very, very cool as well. Got the hats over here. We have 717. We've got the Velcro patch where you can make your own hat. I'll show you that in a second. Savage Garage, Inchain Designs, 717 Palm Tree, all these different designs right here. Now, if you get the one with the Velcro patch, you can go over here, as if you're walking in the shop, online, you can pick out your own flag. We got all kinds of different ones, multi-cams, blue line, all dark. We got the Canadian flags, and yes, if you're from Canada, you can win flags, American flag in green, tan, regular red, red, white, and blue. Number one seller right here for key tags, the student driver. Get one now, they're hot. LMR hoodies right here, got the Bertrand 850 shirt, Bobby's new shirt with the rose and skull on it, very cool. Street Speed shirt in a very nice color combination there. Hoodies right here, the flag with the shift pattern and Street Speed for one of the stripes. And then over here we have the flag with the blue line, 717. Got all these shirts in here, ZR1, distorted ZR1 shirt, a favorite of mine, Inchain Designs. Then you come around on this side, almost through them all, we have the flag shirt, and then the same two designs that are on the hoodies. You gotta get on the website. We have the detail spray over there as well. So much on the website for you. Literally like too much to even show. We have thousands of items and everything counts for you to win the LBZ Duramax. Good luck, guys. If you're wondering if we have stuff in stock, we got it, ready to go. Whole containers of everything.
You wanna see containers?
Yeah, I wanna see containers. They're all shirts. It's freaking wild in here.
Everywhere.
This is kind of like our impromptu stock room until the expansion happens. There's a trash bag. What have we got in here?
Dude, other merch we haven't even launched yet.
Oh, is that the backpacks? The backpacks. Are they going to be up on the site?
We got to get them.
This is exciting.
Embroidered.
The backpacks. Oh, that's right, because we're putting the 717 and the Inchain patches on them.
Yeah, but they came
That's
in.
Gonna be
we
sweet.
And we got more coming.
Beautiful. Backpacks about to be on the site.
Different style.
Again,
this
has a little Velcro there for you.
Legit material, dude. I still rock mine.
Yeah.
From the last year.
Heck
last
yeah.
year's model.
That's sweet.
Isn't that cool saying like that?
Love it.
It's
last year's
model.
Dude, we got the new 2021s in. Anyway, if you enjoyed this upload, give it a big thumbs up and let me know if you are excited to see what happens next with the T-Rex. Hope you guys have a great night. Take care. I will see you in the next one.